Great, and we're on Dancing with Parkinson's. Woohoo! So this week we were going to bring in a little object that we were going to talk about and describe. This is my little object. And then we're also going to dance Rumba for the first time, Afro-Cuban Rumba. We see your shoulders jiggling there, Peter. Fantastic. And then we're going to do a special body of sound and meditation at the end in honor of Tess Diamond, who passed over just the other day. So we're going to do that in respect and honor of her. Great. Who wants to go first and show their little object?
One. Well,
Yeah. Yeah, go on, Peter. Off you go.
my little object is because
Sorry.
we couldn't bring pets here, I've got myself a Kelpie dog,
Oh,
and he's my friend.
oh,
Beautiful, isn't it?
Isn't
And
it
he doesn't
gorgeous?
make a mess, and he doesn't bark, and he doesn't t and I don't take him for walks because he can't keep up.
You don't have to pick up his poo-poos.
No, don't need those little bags.
No, and he keeps his rear end clean.
Oh, that's good. Awesome. I have to. Oh, look, my dog's doing a stretch on the couch and saying, "I know you're talking about me."
Wanted to sleep somewhere, one of the chairs over there.
See? Oh, that's great. You'll probably see Spyro get up off the couch and have a stretch in the middle of class. Lovely, Peter. And what about Helen? What did you manage to find?
My glass bird.
Oh, wow.
Hand-blown glass. And I've got it sitting on a north-facing windowsill where the sun always shining on it. Yeah.
Oh, so
It just,
beautiful.
the sun hits it there and it just sort of glows gold. It's beautiful. Yeah.
Isn't it
Yeah.
stunning?
It's hand-blown and hand-painted.
Wow.
Beautiful, yeah.
So
Very precious.
yes, it is. Yeah, I love it.
So beautiful. Wow. And it's made of glass. It's quite precious, isn't it? What type of bird is it?
A spotted quail thrush.
Oh, of course it is. Yes. Awesome. A spotted
Quail.
quail.
It's a quail thrush. It's a ground-dwelling bird.
Okay.
It's through the otways, but very rare now. Being ground-dwelling and ground nesting, the foxes and cats have had an enormous impact on it.
Yeah, right, of course. Wow. Do we find them in Torquay at all, or are they mostly Aries Inlet otways?
Scrubby bush, like inland from Anglesey a bit. You know, that scrubby heath sort of country. And but I haven't.
They're quite shy, aren't
They're
they?
very, very shy. About the only chance you get to see them is if you're driving along the road and they decide to cross the road in front of you.
Oh, okay.
They would prefer to. They're short flights. They prefer to run rather than than
Fly.
fly.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, I know when I'm walking across the cliff tops in Janjuk, there's a lot of birds that run across the track instead of flying, you know? It's quite funny. Yeah, beautiful, stunning. Thanks, Helen. And Rosemary, what have you got to show?
Well, we started from the word joy, I think, last week when we were talking about it. And I was thinking about how there's not much joy in our lives at the moment. And then I went right back to my mother and Father's Day. And of course, they were married in 1937. That's right. Because I was born in 1938. And so they were war, you know, in between war and depression and everything else. And I know the depression affected them very, very greatly because they had no money, and it affected me because I had no clothes. Some of them got made out of curtains and all sorts of things. And so I decided I'd get my mother's wedding photo. I have got the dress too. Now, so I don't know whether you can see that or not. Can you see
Oh,
that?
yes. Wow.
Wow.
So that was a day of joy for my mother and father.
How beautiful. See if you can hold it up just a little bit further up. Yes, that's it. Look at her dress.
Yeah, well, I've got the dress in here.
Really?
It's a bit big probably to show.
Oh, that's so beautiful. What a precious photo.
Wow.
So lovely. And in front of the mirror. And
yeah, well, it's the most incredible mirror, isn't it?
Oh.
Yes.
So ornate.
Well, there's the tail. We can see the tail of the dress or the trail.
Wow. Yes. It was quite long. Mm.
Goodness.
It was all, my mother made it all by hand.
Oh, goodness.
Someone gave the silk, the satin.
Wow.
She was very slim, wasn't she?
Yes, she was quite small. She wasn't very tall. She was 5'2", I think.
Oh, very good.
Wow, what a work of art. Both the dress and the mirror. And I just love how she's turned her body so that she's able to show the beautiful trail of the wedding.
Yes, that's right.
Mm. Good photo.
It was a professionally taken photo, but she made the dress and everything.
Oh,
and the I used that, and so did Fiona. But,
Really?
I don't know what's happened to it. It seems to have disappeared.
Oh, that's beautiful, Rosemary. Thanks for showing that.
That was my little bit of joy, or brought along this little bit of joy.
Oh, we all need joy in our life, don't we? We really do. Well, I'm going to show you my little piece of joy. This is a handmade heart, you know, with blanket stitching and cotton wool in there. And this is from Pastoral Healthcare Network Australia. And Peter and Helen know that organisation, non-profit organisation. I also do some work with them. And that's why they gave me this little heart, because my job there is being the coordinator of the virtual Pamper Day session that runs for about 2 hours. And these hearts are really special because they're made by the volunteers and they are often given to speakers and people who are giving something of their time to the organisation. And I just thought that that was really beautiful, nice and close to my heart. And also they do give these hearts to mothers who actually have miscarried. And because the woman who started the whole Pastoral Healthcare Network Australia, she, her name is Leonie Rastus, and she's a midwife and a nurse. And so she started Pastoral Healthcare Network Australia as a way to helping women and families through times of grief. Mm. So I love that. It's my heart.
Yes.
Very nice.
Yeah, rather personal.
Like that, don't they?
Yeah, it's good. So, everybody just hold your object up at the moment. And I want you to think about how meaningful this object is to you. You know, it's not really an object. It's a living, important memory. Mm. And it's a living, beautiful, meaningful thing for you. Yeah, woohoo! I love it. Peter's already on the ball. He knows that we're going to make a dance out of this. Great. So Peter's already shaking his dog, wagging the tail. Great. So they're your gestures, Peter. Shaking. We're going to put that into the dance and wagging. Mm. Beautiful. Oh, and the foot as well. I love that. Gorgeous. So, Peter, you're going to remember shaking to represent your kelpie and wagging of the tail and showing the leg, however you want to show the leg. Yeah. I love it. We'll weave that into our choreography. And Helen, what can you think about as an important gesture? I know you were talking about words like shy.
It glows. It glows in the sunlight.
Mm. So glowing. You could do a gesture like that, glowing.
How you do that, glowing.
Yeah, you could do glowing. Glowing, shimmering.
Could you fly? Yeah. Fly much? Doesn't fly much.
No, runs. Runs. Yeah, beautiful. So you could make those your two gestures, this one or this one, and then glowing. Okay. Yeah, beautiful. And rosemary. So you've got your absolutely magnificent special painting there. Well, it looks like a painting from this
photo.
Yeah, it's a photo.
It
looks
like a painting though,
yeah. Yeah, it does, doesn't it? So Rosemary, what do you love about your photo?
Well, I love the love that came because of my parents coming together.
Mm.
They just had two children, one before the war and one after the war.
Okay. Well, immediately when I hear you speak, it's like, so your parents loved each other, they came together, they had one child and then another.
Yes.
So something like, you could do something like...
It was an exposing love.
Yeah, beautiful. So coming together in your heart and then one child... before the war and one child after the war. Is that right?
Yep.
Yeah, great. So you could do something like that in your dance. We'll find ways of bringing that in. And then there's my heart. So I will have gestures, maybe something like this, and feelings of pulsating, representing the love energy. Something like that. This is what's great about dance. There's no right or wrong. It's whatever feels good in the way you want to create it. So I think we certainly should begin. Here's some beautiful music. Let's start in our chair and then we'll make our way to standing. So this is from Cuba. It's called Chan Chan. Let's start with the heart. The heart pulsating. Yeah. The heart pulsating. People coming together as one. So love makes the world go around, people coming together, children, good, and the heart has the rhythm. What about the kelpie? The kelpie loves shaking. Shake your shoulders. It loves shaking. And wagging its tail. And showing its foot. Wagging its tail. Shaking its shoulders as it runs. Lovely. And Helen, your bird is shy. And it will run across wherever you are, run across your pathway. Such shy. Runs across the path. Beautiful. So let's see if you can do any of your own movements now. Our way to standing. So tilting forwards in the chair, out through the top of the head, rocking backwards and forwards, coming to a standing. Lovely. And so for this next song, let's see if we can get you to walk around the chair or be seated on your chair. That's up to you. And we're going, it's with the Buena Vista Social Club from Cuba. So you can add in any of the movements that you just did about wagging the tail, the shoulders of the dog. It could be the shy bird. It could be the bird running across. It could be love of your parents. Or the pulsating heart. Yes, here we go.
Chan chan le daba mira. Yo se lo voy para Margarita.
Together, the dog's tail wagging. And now the Kelpie's shoulders shrugging. Running. Woohoo! Fantastic. Okay, and finding your way gently, coming back down to seated and seating yourself down so that we have sitting bones behind us, the head forwards, and a counterbalance. Feet flat on the floor. And just a simple little rocking forwards and backwards, forwards and backwards. Yeah, good. Feel yourself sitting on the chair with your sitting bones so that you're able to go forwards and backwards, out through the top of the head. Rocking. You might like to hang on to the chair. Good, so you're really stretching your spine out through the top of your head. And just check that your knees are going straight over your toes. So they're in line with your hips. Great. And as you're seated on the chair, let's see if you can keep your hands on the chair, lean out through the top of the head and taking the weight over to one side as you reach towards the floor. Good. Put your hand on the chair, reach towards the floor. Hand on the chair, reach towards the floor. Great. Good. Now let's see if we can put our hand on the chair, reaching up high and leaning over. Reaching up high and coming down. Reaching up high and arching over. Lengthening and coming down. And then let's try both arms. Drop the shoulders down. And both arms come up, put your sitting bones into the chair and reach out through the top of your head, out through your fingers and feel your waist and your abdomen starting to work. Good. Try to keep your navel on your spine, supporting your lower back. And now we're going to lift the fingers up and out wide. That's it. Lovely. And then we'll spiral to the side. We'll put our hand on our thigh and keep spiraling until you get that beautiful stretch between the shoulder blades. And then big deep breath in as you lift the arms up. And we change to the other side. So one hand on the thigh, on the outside of the thigh, and feel the stretch between your shoulder blades. Big breath in as you lift your arms up. Lovely. Turn the palms to the floor and lower. Great. Then we're going to reach to the floor and come up to the floor and come up over to the other side. The floor, reaching with your fingertips and up. Hang on to the opposite chair. That's it. And down and up. Lovely. So let's try that to music. See how we go. So at any time you're feeling like you're a little bit unbalanced, hold on to the sides of the chair. Here's some real Afro-Cuban rumba. It's actually from the Congo.
Thank you.
Rosemary, I'd like you to follow me. Good. And just bring your dance to a little close. Lovely. So Rumba is the dance of love. And Rumba is done all over Africa and all over Cuba, South America. It's actually done all over the world now. Of course, it originated in Africa. And every culture seems to do the Rumba differently. But basically, it's the dance of love. And in Cuba, it's the official dance that represents Cuba is the Rumba. And so Rumba is all about love, the love that we have for another person. But it's not always a romantic love. It could be, you know, I could be dancing, say, for example, with my father. And so it would be a dance of respect. And my father would be leading me in the dance. Or it could be, you know, two friends. It could be two girls dancing or actually two blokes dancing. So it doesn't matter. It's all about sharing the love through the dance. So we're going to have a go at trying to do this Rumba step. And it's a slow step because it has to be in the hips. You have to show the hips off. Yeah. Okay, so let's do this for the next 5 minutes because I'm just conscious of the time. Let's get ourselves to standing and energy out through the top of the head, knees straight ahead. And we're going to shake off a little bit, shake out through our hands and our feet. Good. So with the Rumba, you want to be able to communicate with your hips. So it's, of course, there's the feet involved, but the movement begins at the hips. So it helps to have your hands on your hips and just simply begin by changing your weight from side to side. Good. And as you change your weight from one foot to the other, as you can see, I'm just lifting up my heel. And that helps to shift my weight from side to side. Now, what we do in the dance is that we just have more of a bent knee and we keep our torso straight so we can breathe. And that's how we start to use our hips. So it's like one knee is bent and a little bit more bent than the other side. So both knees are bent, but one knee is bent more than the other. Good. Just have a feel of what that's like to be able to shift your weight from one side of the body to the other. Beautiful. And of course, it has to be done in bent knees, bending of the knees. So that when you dance with a partner, you are swaying from side to side together. Great. So Peter and Helen, you might hold each other now. You can actually hold each other's hands or go into the embrace. Wonderful. I'm going to put the music on and all I want you to practice doing is shifting your weight from side to side. Now, you could also go side together. All I want you to do is practice shifting your weight from side to side. So Helen, you dance with Peter and I'll keep a check with Rosemary that you're getting the steps, Rosemary, all right? Good. So more than anything, it's about sensing and feeling the music. Here it is. And this is the timing. One. Yeah. Beautiful. Very gentle. So it's not about showing off, it's about connecting. Yeah. You might try to slowly turn around on the spot. Find a way to come back down to sitting on your chair, doing the dance of love, the Rumba. The chair, sitting comfortably. Great. So that's the Rumba, the dance of love. And we might practice that every week because, as Rosemary says, we need joy in our life, don't we? And it's love that makes the world go round, not money. Money helps, of course. But if there's love and abundance, the money and abundance is there for us. So lots of love to everybody. And we're going to send our love to beautiful Tess. If you have a candle. And indeed, this is in honour of remembering Tess, who loved dancing with us. I'm sure she's still dancing with us. But you could also light your candle for Any of your loved ones that you want to remember? I certainly remember my father's sister in the Netherlands when I visited his family, and she loved dancing the Rumba. And every time I think about the Rumba, I also think about her. So candles are good to help us to click into remembering a memory. So placing your candle wherever it's safe. And let's begin with our own hand on our hearts. And we're going to just focus in on relaxing, feeling how our body has been moving and using lots of energy. It's great to exercise your body, but let's also focus in on our breath of life. We're going to breathe in through the nose and out through the mouth. Lovely. Breathing in and breathing out. Breathing in, expanding, and breathing out. Great. And then we have our three sounds from the Sanskrit language, the sounds of resonance. So the first one is Aum. So on the bringing your lips slightly together and getting the sound up to the top of your head, feeling it all around the top of your skull. Let's try it again. Lovely. And the next one is I. So it's like it starts in your heart and then expands out from your heart. Let's try it again together. Lovely. And then the next one, it's going to the top of the head and then circling down. And this one is shrim. Lovely. Let's try it again. You can use your arms if you wish, or just use the sound. The first one. And the heart. Top of the head and all the way down to the bottom of the spine. Shrim. Lovely. Let's work through all the body parts now. Top of the head. Mind shrimp. Forehead. Mind shrimp. Gently on your eyelid. Mind shrim. The other eye. Mind shrim. The nostril. Mind shrim. Change. Mind shrim. ear. Mein Schrimm. Change. Mein Schrimm. Gently touching your cheek. Mein Schrimm. Change. Mein Schrimm. The top of your lip. Mein Schrimm. Gently feel the vibration on the bottom of your lip. Mein Schrimm. And your tongue on the top row of teeth. Feel the vibration on the bottom row of teeth. And your tongue on the roof of your mouth. We're going to make a sound right from our diaphragm out our throat. Ha! Lovely. The chin. Mein Schrimm. And your throat. Mein Schrimm. To your heart. Mein Schrimm. Across to your shoulder. Mein Schrimm. Down your arm to your elbow. Mein Schrimm. Down to your wrist. Mein Schrimm. The base of your fingers. Mein Schrimm. Your fingertips. Mein Schrimm. Across to your other shoulder. Mein Schrimm. Down to your elbow. Mein Schrimm. Down to your wrist. Mein Schrimm. Base of the fingers. Mein Schrimm. The tips of the fingers. Mein Schrimm. Let's feel our breath in our lungs. Mein Schrimm. And sending the sound to our liver and stomach. Mein Schrimm. And down to our belly. Mein Schrimm. and across to our hip socket, deep in the hip socket. Om Aum Shrim. Down to the kneecap. Om Aum Shrim. And sliding your hand or even just your thought and your intention down to your ankle. Om Aum Shrim. Down to the base of the toes. Om Aum Shrim. And to the tips of the toes. Om Aum Shrim. And to your heel. Om Aum Shrim. Sliding up the calf muscle to underneath the knee. Om Aum Shrim. Sliding up the side of the leg to the hip joint. Om Aum Shrim. And across to the back of the pelvis. Om Aum Shrim. And across to the other hip, into the hip socket. Om Aum Shrim. Sliding down to the kneecap. Om Aum Shrim. Down to the ankle. With your mind, or you can touch your ankle. Om Aum Shrim. Sliding down to the base of the toes. Om Aum Shrim. To the tips of the toes. Om Aum Shrim. Sliding up to the heel. Om Aum Shrim. And under to the calf muscle, to under the knee. Om Aum Shrim. And up the side of the leg to the hip joint. Om Aum Shrim. Across to the back of the pelvis. Om Aum Shrim. Now we're going to go to the side of the abdomen. Om Aum Shrim. Across to the other side of the abdomen. Om Aum Shrim. And around to the lower back. Om Aum Shrim. And around to the front at the navel. Om Aum Shrim. And we're going to start at the base of the spine and work up. So the lower dantian. We're thinking of the color red and saying to yourself, I am. Om Aum Shrim. Working up to the sacral plexus, the color orange, and saying to yourself, I feel, I express. Om Aum Shrim. shrimp. I'm working up to the solar plexus, the color yellow, saying to yourself, I act, I put things into action. Mind shrimp. And up to the heart, beautiful color green, saying to yourself, I am love. Mind shrimp. Up to the neck, the color blue, I speak. Mind shrimp. And up to the forehead, the color purple, saying to yourself, I understand. Mind shrimp. And the crown of the head, beautiful crystal diamond, and saying to yourself, I know. Mind shrimp. So cocooning yourself in all these beautiful rainbow colors safely in your body. Mind shrimp. And the front and the back and the sides of you. Mind shrimp. All the way from the sky and the sun right down to the earth. Mind shrimp. And let's go right around the planet Earth. Mind shrimp. And let's all just hold Mother Earth. Mind shrimp. And sending those beautiful colors of the light spectrum around the world. Mind shrimp. And to our country. Mind shrimp. And to our community. Mind shrimp. And to each other. Mind shrimp. And to Peter and everybody else who couldn't make it for this part of the session, mind shrimp. And to Tess, mind shrimp. And to your family, mind shrimp. And holding anybody dear to your heart that has passed over. Mind shrimp. And to yourself. Mind shrimp. And to anybody else who needs some extra love at this time. Mind shrimp. And one more for yourself. Mind shrimp. I'm very happy that we could make it late in the afternoon, and I'm sure Pete's around, but this is his napping time. Oh, great. So he was here? Great. Good on you, Peter. Hope you're having a nice little nap, or resting anyway. So this is also in honour of Tess, our beautiful dancer, dancing somewhere else in a beautiful place, I'm sure.
The lovely lady.
Okay, so you're welcome to say anything if you'd like to share anything. Otherwise, we can end on this very lovely, calm note.
Ready for our afternoon nap now.
Yeah. Absolutely. I'm going for a beach walk, I think.
Yes, you've had a big one.
My dog's been very well behaved, waiting for me.
It's still very windy.
I know. I don't, hope you couldn't hear the door slamming downstairs all the time. So annoying. Anyway, better go and shut it. Okay, lovely people, good to see you. did we want to think about what we're going to bring next week to talk about?
Whatever.
I'm never good at inspiration.
Yeah, you could bring whatever. It could be something like, you know, this is my little fairy from Ireland.
All right.
I absolutely love her. I call her Clementina. Oh. And she really loves rabbits. And we have so many rabbits here. They sleep here just in our garden overnight. I know they're pests here, but in Europe or in Ireland there.
Watching that show on television where they go back and they have to kill the rabbits.
Oh, yeah.
Well, you know, we all killed rabbits to eat, feed off.
That's right. I remember my brother and I used to go rabbiting with the ferrets down at Palm Ponds Creek.
That's right.
Catching tadpoles and rabbiting with our ferrets. And we'd cook up rabbit stew. Yum.
Yeah, I love rabbit.
Yeah, lovely. So just bring whatever you think, you know, it might be some funky glasses or whatever. You know, you can talk about whatever. You can decide what you'd like to bring. Probably good to bring something visual so we can see it. Yeah. Okay.
Thanks,
see
Jackie.
See you next week at 11 o'clock this time.
Right.
Okay. Yeah. Bye-bye now. See you.
Bye, Pete. Bye, Helen.
See you next week.
Peter.
You
haven't. Bye, Helen. Bye, Rosemary.
Bye.
Bye.
You haven't heard anything, Helen, from the Parkinson's people.